Congratulations on choosing one of the most innovative and safe hyperbaric chambers. Our patented designs are like no other on the market. Safety is one of our main priorities at Summit to Sea. It is our policy and practice to extensively test all of our chambers to ensure that Summit to Sea chambers have the highest quality, comfort, and safety. Now that you have all the equipment to begin your treatments, it is extremely important to watch this entire video and read the manual that was included on a thumb drive in your packet before operating your chamber. Our hyperbaric chambers are a Class 2 medical device cleared by the FDA requiring a prescription. As we are constantly developing new technology to improve our chambers, there may be photo or video footage that doesn't quite match your chamber. Follow along with the instructional manual on your thumb drive as they will contain the most current updates. Now let's discuss the items that are included in your boxes for your dive hyperbaric chamber. First, we have the chamber in a carry bag. Included with the chamber are two sets of cradles to stabilize the chamber. A foam mat to provide comfort during your treatment. Next, you will see an external frame designed to fit around your chamber. One unique feature of all Summit to Sea chambers is there are two separate compressor systems, which connect to the chamber. Should one of the compressor systems fail, this safety feature allows fresh air to continue to circulate inside of the chamber until you can deflate and exit the chamber. Each compressor hose has a quick connect on the end, which makes it easier to click onto the chamber fill valves. In your Open Me First box, you will find silicone lubricant for the zipper docks, zipper cleaner and lubricant, an auxiliary valve that clicks onto the auxiliary port, a 9-volt battery for your failed circuit alarm, a screwdriver, and a thumb drive that has the instruction manuals in PDF form. If you ever misplaced this thumb drive, you can log on to www.summit-2-c.com/instructions to find your chamber's manual. The failed circuit alarm is to alert you in the event of a power outage. To give you an overview of the steps to install and operate your chamber, we will discuss connecting the compressors, Summit to Sea's zipper system, inflating the chamber, connecting the cradles, building the frame, and mat installation. Now it is time to connect the compressors to the electrical outlet. Please note that some wall sockets are configured so that one of the outlets is connected to a light switch. Avoid using these outlets as they could result in loss of airflow to your chamber. The following diagrams will describe several options for connecting your compressors to the electrical wall outlet. First, install the 9-volt battery that was included in your packet into the circuit alarm. Plug the circuit alarm into the power outlet. Then plug one of the compressors into the back of the circuit alarm plug. Next, plug the second compressor into the other wall outlet. If you are using a power strip, be sure that it is UL approved. You will plug the circuit alarm into the wall outlet, then plug the power strip into the circuit alarm plug. Next, plug your compressors into the power strip. For additional configurations, refer to your manual. Now it's time to assemble your dive hyperbaric chamber. Bring the carry bag over to where you intend to have your chamber. Remove the chamber from the carry bag. Ensure that you have plenty of room to maneuver while assembling your chamber. Move the carry bag out of the way of the chamber. Now it is important to make sure that you lay out the chamber so the zipper is facing up. Check that the buckles on the chamber are securely buckled. This allows the zipper to line up, making it easier to zip and taking stress off the zipper. Now you will need to close both the internal and external zippers to inflate the chamber. First, close the internal zipper. Notice that the zipper has a dock at the opening of the zipper. You can apply a zipper lubricant on the dock to ease the closure. When the internal zipper pull is placed into the dock, an airtight seal is created. Summit to Sea provides a unique two zipper combination, one internal airtight zipper and one external mechanical zipper. As you can see the picture on the right, the slider is fully closed into the dock. On the left is an example of a zipper not properly zipped. Notice how it's not in the dock. If the slider is not completely seated into the dock, the chamber will not fully pressurize. Once the internal zipper is zipped, close the external zipper. Slowly zip the zipper while going under the buckles. To be sure it is fully zipped, pull the zipper string under the safety strap. You will not see the slider when it is fully closed. Now, in order to continue with inflation, it is time to turn on both compressors. Grab the compressor hoses and walk them over to the chamber. Now connect the compressor hoses to the chamber. These fill valve connectors are located on the back of your chamber. It is recommended to first put a small dot of silicone lubricant on the O-ring on the end of each fill valve connector. This will ease the connection of the hose to the fill valve. Simply click both hoses onto the fill valves. Make sure the red deflation valve is in the closed position. When both compressors are connected, they should look like this. Now wait for the chamber to inflate so you can connect the stabilizer cradles and assemble the frame. Once the chamber is to shape, connect the stabilizer cradles to the bottom of the chamber. Lift the chamber one end at a time. Slide the stabilizer cradles under the chamber and connect them to the Velcro patches that are located on the chamber. Make sure that the cradles are aligned correctly with the Velcro to ensure that your chamber sits properly. Now that you've connected the cradles to the chamber, it is time to build the frame around the chamber. Lay out all the pieces of the frame, which include two sets of arches, two end pieces, and six poles. To begin, place both arches into the end pieces. Now place the end pieces at each end of the chamber. Two of the poles have end caps. These screw together and will go over the top of the chamber. Screw the other two pairs of poles together. You will now have three long poles. Place one of the poles without caps in the front of the chamber and insert it into the connector on the end pieces. Repeat this on the back side of the chamber. Attach the last pole to the two arches using the included screwdriver. Do not over-tighten the screws. Now connect each Velcro strap to the frame. Do not put the frame through the black zipper handle. This is not meant for the frame. After you assemble the frame around the chamber, your chamber should look like this. Now you can deflate the chamber by turning the red deflation valve. It is designed to turn in either direction to release air from the chamber. As you turn the knob, you will notice that you have control of the speed of deflation. When the gauge reads zero, you can unzip the external and internal zippers. Then unbuckle the belts, pushing the gold levers towards the opposite side. Now that the chamber is deflated and attached to the frame, it is time to slide the foam mat inside the chamber. Slide the foam mat inside the chamber. Congratulations, you have successfully set up your dive chamber. Now we will go over the operation of the chamber. First, ensure that both compressors are on. make sure that the red deflation valve is closed. First, the person will enter the chamber. From the outside, as previously demonstrated, you will buckle the belts. Again, this will keep pressure off of the zippers once they are zipped. Once the buckles are buckled, zip both zippers. The zipper can also be closed from the inside, as our zippers have zipper pulls on both sides. When it's time to end your treatment, you will turn the red deflation valve to deflate the chamber. Once the chamber sides are soft and the gauge reads zero, unzip both zippers. Then unbuckle the belts and exit the chamber. For independent use, you will need to reconfigure the internal zipper. This is the view inside of the chamber. In this picture, the zippers are not configured for individual use. To configure, move both zipper sliders to the right. When looking at the zippers from the inside, this is what it will look like when it is configured for individual use. Make sure both compressors are turned on before entering the chamber. Connect the end buckle by the head, then step into the chamber. Connect the remaining buckles. Pull the external zipper all the way closed. Then close the internal zipper all the way, making sure it's seated in the dock. The chamber will be inflated to full pressure. When your treatment is done, turn the inside red deflation valve to release the air. Wait until the internal gauge reads zero and the chamber is soft. Then unzip the internal and external zippers. Reach out and unbuckle the two center buckles. And step out. Now we would like to give you a more detailed explanation of the individual components on your chamber and their function. There are two pressure relief valves with blue circles. These are designed and factory calibrated to equalize the pressure at 1.3 ATA or 4.4 PSI. They are located at each end of the chamber. There's a safety backup pressure relief valve with a yellow circle which is set to open at a slightly higher pressure than the blue valves. There may be a slight venting of air, which is normal. Next, you will see the color-coded gauge. The needle will start at the bottom of the black area at zero. Once the chamber is fully pressurized, air will be released out of the blue pressure relief valves and the needle will appear in the blue area. If the needle is anywhere within the blue area, you are at full pressure. These gauges are accurate to plus or minus 5%. If the needle appears past the yellow area, stop use and call your distributor. There's also an internal gauge which operates similar to the exterior gauge. The only difference is the external gauge needle moves clockwise and the internal gauge needle moves counterclockwise. On the back of the chamber, there are two fill valves. Next to the window is an auxiliary port where the auxiliary valve attaches. This small auxiliary valve is located in your packet along with the zipper cleaner, zipper lubricant, and thumb drive. There are also two additional ports, one at each end of the chamber. These are for additional accessories. The red deflation valve is designed to turn in either direction to release air from the chamber. This valve can also be used during pressurization to customize the speed of inflation for greater comfort and to aid in the equalization of ear pressure. If uncomfortable ear pressure is felt, there are several ways to relieve this pressure. The first, pinch your nose, close your mouth, and try gently blowing out your nose. Repeat every time you begin to feel that pressure. This technique is called the Valsalva maneuver. Drinking water during inflation can help the pressure on your ears as well. Yawning or opening your mouth wide will also help. Lastly, chewing gum may help relieve this pressure as well. If the above suggestions do not resolve the ear pressure, open the red deflation valve until the feeling of pressure is gone, then close the red deflation valve to continue to pressurize the chamber. The red deflation valve will allow you to control the speed of pressurization and to aid in equalizing the pressure on your ears. We hope that this short video has been helpful for you to become more familiar and comfortable when operating your chamber. It is very important to heed these few important reminders. Remember, make sure all buckles are closed and both the inside and outside zippers are completely closed every time the chamber is in use. Failure to do this may result in an inability to pressurize or damage the chamber. If the blue relief valves do not release air when it is at full pressure, stop your treatment and call your distributor. It is important that the relief valves are clear of all obstructions inside and out during your treatment. The compressors must remain on for the entire treatment. This ensures the circulation and exchange of fresh air to provide a safe and comfortable treatment. Do not open the zippers or unbuckle the straps until the gauge reads zero. Congratulations on completing your setup. Summit to See believes that you have purchased one of the best chambers on the market, and you will be completely pleased with the ease of use and the quality of craftsmanship. Summit to See also believes that we have the best customer service of any hyperbaric chamber company on the market. We will always try our best to be available and give you prompt service. If you have any questions regarding your chamber, please contact your distributor first. If you have any additional questions, please visit our website at www.summit-2-c.com/support and fill out the form. If you need immediate assistance, you can call 1-877-774-3483. It is highly recommended to watch this video a second time. Also, anyone else who may be operating this chamber needs to watch this video. By doing this, it will ensure a safe environment for all who will be benefiting from the use of this chamber.